Nothing in life is free. You've undoubtedly heard that before, but not quite like this. For a woman who runs a small cafe in Waldo, that message was part of a threat. And as KMBC 9's Jim Flink reports, it was also a lesson in small business affairs.
Here at the Classic Cookie, they were going along business as usual when one day a letter arrived in the mail. In it, a threatening message that made them change the way they did business.
For Halloween, we're having ghosts and pumpkins and bats.
For 10 years, Leslie Stockard has owned and operated the Classic Cookie and Cafe.
How are you today?
A place she calls her second home.
I'm a very small business. You know, I'm just trying to make a nice living for myself and my family.
That nice life was thrown askew when this letter arrived with a threatening message.
I thought it was a scam, so I kept tossing the letters, and the letters came more frequently.
It was from BMI, an agency which represents music artists. Leslie ignored it until one day a customer came in to deliver the threat in person.
So, you know, we turned him off for a week and figured he was gone, and so then we turned him back on. I assumed, as I'm sure other small businesses do, that if you purchase, my business purchased the CDs, that would entitle me to play them in my place of business. Apparently that's not the case.
In a flash, Leslie learned something she didn't know.
You guys heading out?
That music isn't meant to be shared unless you pay the price first.
Well, I'd like to make sure other small businesses know, turn off your CDs unless you want to pay a licensing fee.
And so Leslie Stockard is now paid up through next May, which means she can continue to play her CDs till then. Then she will revert to playing the radio so that she doesn't get one of these letters again. In Waldo, Jim Flink, KMBC 9 News.
Now, in all, Stockard paid $300 in BMI licensing fees. That's the minimum for 1 year's use. It's good, again, for 1 year from last May when her practice of playing those CDs